another video, and this one is a customer that's brought his car in, and he says it's got a vibration, mostly on tick over. He can feel a little bit on driving, but as I say, tick over, the car is actually shaking. So first thing we did is had a quick look, and we plugged the scanner in, and there was no fault codes, nothing at all. But what we did have, we looked into the smooth running, all the injectors were running fine as well. So we started to think there wasn't anything wrong with the engine. So I'll show you what the engine was doing, and you can make your own mind up. Vibrating, and you can feel it in the driver's seat. So I thought, well, where do we go from here? And I thought we could actually get a piece of kit out I got, which is called the Pico NVH, noise, vibration and harshness, and I'd give that a go. And all that consists of is a magnet, and this. Then let's just take you out a bit more. This fits into a little box, and then the little box fits into the oscilloscope, and then that records what you've got. And what this little thing here does, in it picks up, is when it's sitting on there. So X picks things this way, and then you've got Y up and down. And then you've got Z, which is obviously goes the other way, and it can pick up whatever's going on which you can't see. And I got quite interested in that. As I say, I must have went to up to a course up in Preston to watch a guy. Well, it was a Pico thing, and old Frank Massey was doing a bit of a demonstration. I'd only just started getting into the Pico, and I thought, wow, this NVH could be quite good, but I needed to learn how to use the Pico first. So, and I've got reasonably okay with that now. And then I've started buying the NVH, because the curiosity, yeah, certainly bit the cat, I'm telling you. And we're going to try the NVH. So this is what we got, and this is the capture of the picture. So I've done a capture of say 48 seconds, and let's turn you over. And at the moment I've got an actual vibration of 981 milligrams, which might not sound a lot, but you can actually feel it, and it's quite disturbing. And normally an E1 means crankshaft, flywheel, one turn. Every one turning of the crankshaft is what gives a vibration. E5, now normally you could actually pick that up as a misfire. And this is what I've been learning, as I say, slowly but surely. An E1.5, well, that's 1.5 times. And then we got an E2. An E2 is something that's going twice as fast as what the crankshaft pulley is. Well, that's what I've got, and if anyone can help me out on that one, I'm always willing to learn. So, I've definitely got something going on with the flywheel, and I'm pretty sure I'm now looking at that vibration is caused by the flywheel. So I thought, well, let's try, and put my foot on the clutch So we've put our foot on the clutch and now it's gone up to 1.21. But I'm gonna be honest, you can't actually feel it through the actual clutch pedal. All it's happening is the car is, you can feel it through the car. And I'm quite happy now that I'm going to be taking this gearbox out and that mass flywheel has had it. So we run the customer up and said, look, I'm about 95% sure now that I'm going to take your gearbox out and it is a mass flywheel problem. Looking at what I've got here, and I actually trust what I've got there. And the customer was, yep, get on with it, Trev. I'm going away on Friday. And I mean, we've got it in on Wednesday, so he wants it back. Okay, let's get on with it. And that's what we did. So now I'm going to show you what we found when we got the actual gearbox out. And you can see what happens there. I'll leave that one with you for a few seconds. There somewhere. Right, now you've actually seen what the flywheel looks like and the amount of actual noise and play that was in there. So we were quite happy to swap that out. Anyway, put it all back together again. And first thing I want to do is I want to put the old scope back on it. And what I didn't do first time, and I'm quite mad with myself really, but you know, hindsight's a great thing, is I should have put one of the magnets on the driver's seat, because that would have picked up the actual amount of vibration going through the car, and it would have helped out what I'm going to show you now. And I think that would have been a lot more beneficial. But as I say, we swapped the clutch round, put it all back in together, and now I'm going to show you what readings I got when we've swapped them round. And let's just get you on the old picture here, and let's have a look at the third one. And the third one, now what we've got now, and as you can see now, this is E1-ing. And if you remember rightly, we were what, up to 1.3, the other one was 991 before I put my foot on the clutch. Same amount of time, about 44 seconds I've actually captured. I quite like the bar graph. As I say, you can actually have frequency, so you can see E1, which is only running 17, E2 up there, you can drag it down. Now, after I actually finished this, I've now got 985 on E2. So I didn't have time to actually investigate that. And the other thing is, I didn't actually feel it through the car. And I said to the customer, I don't know what it is. It could be a pulley. It could be... to be honest, I'm guessing. I don't know what it is, but I can't see anything that's serious that's going to go wrong. But as I say, my bar graph, which now at this point over the whole complete lot, it's only 264 mg, which, to be honest, that's fine. That is fine. I don't really understand what went wrong there. But if you look at E1, 16.4 mg. And if we go on the frequency, that one there. Now, let's just lift that up. Now, This here, this yellow line, see the yellow line at the bottom there? Now that's the one I actually put on the driver's seat. And you can see, this is what I can actually feel in the car. And obviously something happened here, because it did pick it up, but it was in the driver's seat. I could only feel 5.57 mg, which was, I couldn't feel that at all. And this is what, but I believe if I'd have hindsight, have actually put this on the driver's seat before we changed the clutch, I believe it would have been a long way up here. It really would have been, because you could feel it. The seat was really giving it like this. So I'm going to actually what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you now what the engine was like after we finished putting the clutch in and everything like that, and you can see the difference of the shaking and what was going through the actual car. I hope this makes sense, because it's I think it's going to be a good thing for when we when the electric cars come, and you're going to hear noises and you're going to think, wow, what the hell's that, where the petrol and diesel engines covered up that noise, and it would have been there before. It just took a lot longer to find the problem when it came through. But an electric car, you're going to know the noise straight away. And this is why I want to get further into this NVH, and perhaps if anyone else has got any ideas, I'd like that as well. So let me show you this engine, and as I say, the customer more than happy. He's taken it away, and next time it comes in, I'll have a look and see if I can find that E2, but we'll go from there. Anyway, let me show you the engine.